The sanctified life, no sanctification without obedience. I have met many who claimed to live without sin. But when tested by God's word, these persons were found to be open transgressors of His holy law. The clearest evidences of the perpetuity and binding force of the fourth commandment failed to arouse the conscience. They could not deny the claims of God, but ventured to excuse themselves in breaking the Sabbath. They claimed to be sanctified and to serve God on all days of the week. Many good people, they said, did not keep the Sabbath. If men were sanctified, no condemnation would rest upon them if they did not observe it. God was too merciful to punish them for not keeping the seventh day. They would be counted singular in the community should they observe the Sabbath, and would have no influence in the world. And they must be subject to the powers that be. A lady in New Hampshire bore her testimony in a public meeting that the grace of God was ruling in her heart and that she was wholly the Lord's. She then expressed her belief that these people were doing much good in arousing sinners to see their danger. She said, "The Sabbath that these people present to us is the only Sabbath of the Bible," and then stated that her mind had been very much exercised upon the subject. She saw great trials before her, which she must meet if she kept the seventh day. The next day she came to meeting and again bore her testimony, saying that she had asked the Lord if she must keep the Sabbath, and He had told her she need not keep it. Her mind was now at rest upon that subject. She then gave a most stirring exhortation for all to come to the perfect love of Jesus, where there was no condemnation to the soul. This woman did not possess genuine sanctification. It was not God who told her that she could be sanctified while living in disobedience to one of His plain commandments. God's law is sacred, and none can transgress it with impunity. The one who told her that she could continue to break God's law and be sinless was the prince of the powers of darkness, the same who told Eve in Eden through the serpent, "Ye shall not surely die." Genesis 3 verse 4. Eve flattered herself that God was too kind to punish her for disobedience of His express commands. The same sophistry is urged by thousands in excuse of their disobedience of the fourth commandment. Those who have the mind of Christ will keep all of God's commandments irrespective of circumstances. The Majesty of Heaven says, "I have kept my Father's commandments." John 15 verse 10. Adam and Eve dared to transgress the Lord's requirements, and the terrible result of their sin should be a warning to us not to follow their example of disobedience. Christ prayed for His disciples in these words, "Sanctify them through Thy truth. Thy word is truth." John 17 verse 17. There is no genuine sanctification except through obedience to the truth. Those who love God with all their heart will love all His commandments also. The sanctified heart is in harmony with the precepts of God's law, for they are holy, just, and good. The Sanctified Life, Chapter 8, The Ministry of John.